Welcome back to another video. Today it's about some new presets I created for my Patreons. And you need to be a subscriber to my Patreon to actually download these new presets. And there's also this a button below this video where you can subscribe here on YouTube called membership. You can also download these presets, of course. Yeah, these two presets are called Little Looper Synced and Little Looper Raw. And I want to explain you how it works and what you can do with it. And yeah, maybe it's also interesting to dissect these presets because I invested a lot of time to actually get rid of some of the problems surrounding creating this preset. So yeah, let's switch over here to Bitwig. And I have here a polysynth running, just a random synth line. Also here, a note clip, just playing some notes, nothing really important. So now we need to call here the little looper raw or little looper synced. And I start here with the synced one and it looks like this. So now we can start here playing back the synth line and you can hear it's, you can't hear anything. This loop section here, a loop preset completely blocks the audio. So this is how it sounds. Fry. So nothing special. But now you can start and press your loop one. And when you press the button, it delays the recording until the bar is over. So it's quantized to the project tempo and your current project. So just press, and it also doesn't matter if you just press it and leave it on or if you press it and switch it off instantaneously, it doesn't matter. It starts recording exactly in time on the bar and it stops recording at the end of the bar. And then it starts immediately to loop this recorded audio. So now it's recorded this and it plays it back and you can switch here the polysynth off and you can hear it's just playing the audio back here. So now we can go in here and maybe change the setting of the polysynth. Or maybe make this a bit scale 50%. Maybe not too short, maybe 200%. Okay, so now we have a different loop here running in front and record this into maybe loop four. And again, we can switch this off here. And now you can see we have two loops recorded into these two slots here and we can play around with this and we can just start to record this again at every time. Or maybe again switch here settings a bit. And also important, these loops here have different loop length, and my default settings are pretty much, this is I think exactly one bar and this is a half of a bar, and these two are here a bit uneven, so you get or can create some kind of polyrhythmic loops. So if you don't want this and you want to have straight loops, then you can go into here this section and go to the scalars of each of these loop slots here and can change the settings, and this will change the loop length. Okay, so if you want to customize this. Then we have here a second page where you can change the pan for each slot, and you can also change the start time or the start offset when you want to start in within this bar or within this project timing here. So now it's back to original. make this a bit shorter here again, and let's record this. Oh, it's a bit too fast. So as you can hear, this loop here is a bit uneven compared to these two. But it can be interesting sometimes when you sample percussions. So I hope this makes it clear how this works. It's just a little loop station. You can record in time, quantize to your project tempo, and then it plays back this looping. And it's maybe interesting when you use vocals or an external synth, or when you play around on your Eurorack and you just want to record a small portion of the sound and you want to loop it. Or maybe you make some sound experiments with your noise box. Or I don't know. There are a lot of use cases for this. So this is little looper synced. And then we have here a little looper raw. And this one is kind of the same. So let's make the sound active again. Double content. Oh no, actually scale it up. This one is a bit different. It has also four loop slots here, but here it's important when you press this button and when you release this button, because you can start anytime and you can stop anytime. It's not quantized to the project tempo, so you can basically just hit record and immediately stop. And then also this time frame decides how long the loop length is, and this also decides then probably how the rhythm sounds or how fast the rhythm is. So I can record, stop, and then loop back. So you can just make a pretty short loop if you want to. So this is more like for when you don't want to synchronize everything to a song or to a project and you want to sync maybe to an external source. Maybe you have here, instead of polysynth, you have a radio. I don't know. Let's see here. This is something chill from the radio. So you can just hit here. So you can start something in a different rhythm. And you can also turn this off here. It's completely now inside the grid. Okay. And then the second page is also a bit different. Here we have also pan, but then we have your restart, which are also at the same time play buttons. So when you go with this here, it basically just stops to play, but then you can start start the playback at any time. What this means is you can also restart. So if you hook this up here to an LFO, like this one here, so you can restart this here with an LFO, it's also possible, okay? Also possible is that you go back here to page one and use maybe a steps mod and say I want to record here at the first two bars. Maybe go with the smoothing up here a bit so we have just one gate signal. Record loop, use a different steps mod here, use an uneven number maybe, record this, go here, record this. Well, maybe go to 10. Maybe record here 9. Something like this. And now you record basically here at different points and you play back in different times. And how many steps you paint in decides how long the loop is, basically. So this is a longer loop. This one is even longer. This is a short one. This one is super short. And then you get at the end something that's maybe usable. If you, it's kind of an weird delay effect, an uneven delay effect, and if you put here some reverb on it to diffuse the signal a bit, it can become a nice reverb or delay reverb, or, you know, nice tool for sound design. So it's basically just recording at different points in time, looping differently, playing back differently. You can also try to replace here the steps with the random or with the dice modulator. This can also work. But this is a pretty nice effect here also when you use your voice. I don't know, maybe use an audio thing here, put this on. Maybe just move this here. And this should be my voice here. So let's try this out. It's perfect. So yeah, a lot of possibilities with this, with these two little loopers. You can also, of course, step in and maybe dissect the preset and learn something from it or replace some of the modules and yeah, just have fun with it. So yeah, maybe tell me what you think down in the comments about this, about these presets. If you have fun with it, if you have problems, let me know. Maybe I can update it over the week with some fixes. Maybe there are some problems. I don't know. I tried this out yesterday and it works kind of nice. Also with the raw version here, I tried to get rid of all the clicks and pops when you start recording or playback, you know, not exactly at the zero crossing. So I implemented some ADSRs in there and some delays here and there just to get rid of the clicks and pops. Okay. So that's it for this video. Thanks for watching. Tell me what you think. Subscribe to my Patreon or here on YouTube with the membership and you can download this. Tell me what you think and thanks for watching. See you on the next video. Bye.